No one doubted now that the mystery of this murder would be immediately brought to light. But although in one or two instances arrests were made which promised elucidation, yet nothing was elicited which could implicate the parties suspected, and they were discharged forthwith. Strange as it may appear, the third week from the discovery of the body had passed, and passed without any light being thrown upon the subject, before even a rumor of the events which had so agitated the public mind reached the ears of Dupin and myself. Engaged in researches which absorbed our whole attention, it had been nearly a month since either of us had gone abroad or received a visitor, or more than glanced at the leading political articles in one of the daily papers. The first intelligence of the murder was brought to us by G., in person. He called upon us early in the afternoon of the 13th of July, and remained with us until late in the night. He had been piqued by the failure of all his endeavors to ferret out the assassins. His reputation, so he said with a peculiarly Parisian air, was at stake. Even his honor was concerned. The eyes of the public were upon him, and there was really no sacrifice which he would not be willing to make for the development of the mystery. He concluded a somewhat droll speech with a compliment upon what he was pleased to term the tact of Dupin, and made him a direct, and certainly a liberal, proposition, the precise nature of which I do not feel myself at liberty to disclose, but which has no bearing upon the proper subject of my narrative.